We're going to take a look at each of the phases of the moon in order from three different perspectives. The first is sort of the outside the solar system view, where we're looking down on the Earth. We've got our observer. The moon is orbiting around the Earth, and then we have sunlight coming in from far, far away. So that's our first view to understand sort of the geometry of the sun, moon, and Earth. The second view is going to be just what if we were looking at the moon through a telescope, you know, what would its phase look like? And the third view is sort of our familiar horizon diagram view, where we're actually going to see on the sky where is the moon and the sun in relation to one another. All right, so this is always going to show us at noon. This is going to start at noon, and then we're going to set time going forward. So I'm going to start this animation. And we'll see that the Earth is rotating around. Look at that. We just did one day. Boom. So it goes pretty fast, all right? So one day into this cycle now, we can see there's a tiniest sliver of the crescent moon starting to show. Right? And I just want to illustrate here how the moon has moved away from the sun. And notice it's moving east of the sun. This is the opposite direction that stars seem to move normally, right? So like normally stars rise in the east and set in the west. Well, from day to day, the moon is moving further and further east. All right, now we normally wouldn't notice this little crescent because it's up in the daytime. It's so close to the sun still on our sky, right? From the observer, they're looking at the sun. The moon is still really close to the sun on the sky. So in the daytime, it's hard to see such a sliver unless you know exactly where to look and you're looking through a telescope. But let's set time going a little further, right? So another day passes, the moon is getting further away from the sun, and our crescent is getting bigger, right? We're seeing more and more of the illuminated part of the sun. So I'll pause it right there. We're now bona fide a waxing crescent. Remember, waxing means it's getting brighter and brighter, or the phase is getting bigger and bigger, and crescent means it's this kind of nice crescent shape. All right, now at this point, the moon is still up mostly in the daytime, right? So by the time the moon, but this is where we see it, right? The sun sets, you'll notice the sun setting down here, and we see this beautiful crescent moon. So typically, we'll see this waxing crescent just after sunset for a few hours until the sun sets, and until the moon sets. Let's keep going, right? Once the moon gets here to first quarter, we'll see it's exactly half illuminated, and the moon is exactly halfway behind the sun. So if I pause it right there, we're a little past this point, right? But that means the sun would have been right there at the meridian, we call it. All right, we'll keep going. Now we're at this gibbous phase where it's not quite full, but it's bigger than halfway. We're at the waxing gibbous because it's still getting brighter and brighter. And we'll make our way all the way around to the full moon. And we'll notice now, let's look at the full moon from three different perspectives, all three perspectives. Let's see, I'll wait till right here. Okay, so the moon is on the complete opposite side of the Earth as the sun, right? And that's why we're seeing the fully illuminated half of the moon. The dark half of the moon is something we aren't seeing right now. Right, but well, so that's the view we're seeing right here. We see that at nighttime we're going to see that. But now in the middle of the day, right, if I look down here, we're not going to see the full moon, of course, because the full moon is on the complete opposite side of the sky. Right, so if I let time go forward a little bit more until sunset, boom, all right, is what we typically see. When the sun is setting, if it's a full moon, the full moon will just be rising because they're on opposite sides of the sky. So this is why you'll always see a full moon rising right around dusk, which makes it all the more beautiful, I think, right, because it's just getting dark and this huge full moon starts rising. Okay, so as we go a little further now, again, the full moon is going to be up all night long, right? So we'll only see the full moon when it's completely dark outside. You'll never see a full moon in the daytime. Now, as we keep going, you'll notice that as we look at the actual phase of the moon, the darkness, right, is sort of coming from the same direction as the light was. So the moon started being illuminated from the right, and then it starts getting dark from the right as well. So we're at this waning gibbous as the moon is losing some of its brightness, the waning. All right, and now we're at the third quarter moon. Now, most of the time, we probably don't see the third quarter moon because it's up very early in the morning. Let's check this out. So the sun sets right here, okay? It means that this third quarter moon doesn't rise until, like, after midnight. So there is 3 a.m., right? And it sets, right, after it's already daytime. So sometimes we'll see this in the early morning. We'll say, hey, the moon's up during the daytime, and you'll still see it. But generally, you're not going to see these waning crescents unless you stay up really, really late or you get up quite early. All right, so we keep going now, the waning crescent, and of course the moon is getting closer and closer to the sun again on our sky. And eventually we come all the way back around to a new moon. All right, so hopefully you see here that we can actually tell where to look in the sky for what phase we're looking at, right? So like if we want to see the full moon, we're only going to see it right around sunset. It's going to be rising, and we'll see it all night long, etc. You get the idea. So there's lots of different ways to be looking at these lunar phases. Now, I just want to show you one more way of addressing this question of when we get to the new moon and the full moon, why don't we see an eclipse? Right? You'd think, well, hey, the moon is going to be blocking the sun. Well, here's a great way to see this visualized. So let's take a look and try to understand why eclipses don't happen every single month. This is a nice simulation, and it shows the Earth-Moon system from the perspective of the sun. So if we were looking through a telescope, we might see the Earth like this. And if we were looking just with binoculars, perhaps we'd see the Earth and the Moon kind of like this. And what's nice is it shows the orbit of the Moon. Now, this is kind of deceiving, right? The Moon actually orbits in almost a perfect circle around the Earth, right? This is just from the perspective of the Sun. It looks kind of like it's this tilted thing, right? Now, as the Earth and Moon orbit around the Sun's perspective, if you will, on this orbit changes. So I'm going to do this sort of in fast motion, okay? You see the whole calendar of a year down below. If I go forward and backward time, I want you to see how the orbit kind of its tilt kind of changes from the perspective of the Sun. You see how it's kind of like moving around. Now, this is entirely because the Earth and Moon are orbiting around the Sun. That's why our perspective changes. But check it out. I mean, certain times of the year then, there's really no chance of an eclipse. Like right here, right? The path of the moon is completely above or below the Earth, so there's not going to be any eclipse. But in other times of the year, certain eclipse seasons, the tilt lines up so that the moon could pass directly between the Earth and the sun, right? Or it could pass right behind the Earth in the shadow, of the Earth. So we're only going to see an eclipse if you happen to have like a new moon phase or a full moon phase during one of these eclipse seasons. So really there's only a few weeks every year where an eclipse would even be possible. And then eclipse doesn't even necessarily happen during those couple weeks.